Hello, my name is Lewis Cooper.
And I'm Kimberly Cooper.
And we're from Stuttgart, Germany. And I flew thousands of miles to come see Asani and Danielle. I was on a mission. I was on a mission to fix my family. And my wife and I were in a bad way.
So he was willing to come here and to be a part of this intensive where I was extremely apprehensive and wondering what the actual motives were for this weekend intensive. And I have to say that I didn't have a whole lot of faith in the process initially. When I came here, I only shared with Hassani at the time that I had 30% invested. And by the time we finished, after we did a letter to each other, from 30% to 100%. And when I wrote 100% that I was willing to show up, to be there, to be in this marriage, to participate at 100%, I also realized that I needed to decrease the rigidness that I had, the emotional value that I had, the stoic behaviors that I had. So one of the things I thought was extremely pivotal moment for me was when Hassani and Danielle were so raw, so truthful, and so authentic. They showed up for us in a way we hadn't even began to show up for ourselves.
That's true.
And they made that clear.
They didn't take any sides. That's what I love about it. No one took any sides.
And they pulled no punches.
They pulled no punches. I opened up more during this intensive.
I learned things about him I never knew. And it took Hassani and Danielle to push us to those places that we had limits for. To those dark places that we weren't ready to go to. Things were revealed between the two of us that were dark and uncomfortable, but were a relief, right?
Yeah.
A relief after we revealed them. And it didn't seem uncomfortable in front of Danielle and Hassani. It seemed like they were a part of the family, cheering us on,
right?
You know, from the sidelines, but pushing us to give more.
I would like to say is this: don't treat your marriage like a used car. Treat it like a broken arm. When you have a car that is a used car that's already broken down, you're willing to throw it away. Don't throw away your marriage. Treat it like a broken arm. Because your arm can heal. Your marriage can heal. Your love can heal.
What I realized in this weekend was that he held the torch with the fire burning when I was exhausted and he put it down. And he picked it up and he kept it going so that we could get to this moment in this time.